Hey, thank you for coming by Tori Magoo 44. Today is the day before Mother's Day 2018. And now I'm going to make a video on that, but first I want to make a video about my friend Arnie Lerma, who probably most of you, I don't know how many of you know him or not. He was a friend of mine that I knew from the 70s. Then he left the Church of Scientology. I stayed in for a long, long time. When I got out, we connected back up and we've been friends ever since for 18 years. He has a site, lermanet.com, if you want to read the various sites. You can type in Google Arnaldo Lerma and you will be able to see him and hear him and different stuff. He was a very interesting guy. But unfortunately, in the last few years, I mean, he suffered from pain for about 10 years. And he told me that he had like really bad back pain and he tried to get back surgeries. One of them helped him a bit, the other one didn't work at all. So he ended up on some pain pills, and I think that's what ended up with in April. He ended up shooting his wife, not killing her, but shooting her, and then locking himself in the bedroom or in the bathroom and then taking his own life. And it's kind of a tragic story because he's a wonderful guy. He's another example of the Church of Scientology who ran programs on him back when I was in. Arnie Lerma's a kook, he's nuts. They were always trying to, make people think less of him because he had a lot of information out there that he was posting on his lermanet.com, right? And anyway, I'm sure they have continued this program. Now, a bunch of the critics are fighting with each other. Some understand Arnie and understand, that it was a combination of serious paranoia from the Church of Scientology running gaslighting him, basically. And if you don't know what gaslighting is, look it up. And they're fair game, which Hubbard said you can lie, cheat, steal, destroy someone utterly, right? So there's that. Then he had serious pain. He was on painkillers, oxycodone, and he had a gun in the house. And that combination, if you are with anyone like that, get out of the house. Because none of us could have seen this. I mean, if someone said to me 10 years ago, excuse me, pardon me, one of your friends is going to take his life and shoot his partner, who do you think it is? Arnie would have been the last person I would have thought of. And that's true for most people. And I mean, I really miss him. I miss him a lot. And but I miss him so much I wasn't able to make a video about it. I just couldn't. I've had a very hard time with it. And the worst part of it is that these critics are attacking his wife, who I know he loved and I know he was in pain. I didn't know he was on oxycodone. And it's like just unbelievable to me that people, ex-Scientologists, would attack someone who was shot in the face. It's just sort of like, and now they're attacking me because I was helping her. It's a very small group of kind of bullies that have bullied different people on the internet. So you can always see them because they've always got kind of shit that they're posting, and that's their stuff. It's like you feel icky when you see it. That's those guys. And I'm not going to say their names. They know exactly who they are. They're trying to pretend that they were really good friends with me. Well, a really good friend doesn't do stuff like that. They just don't. And it's just awful. So for me, it's been tremendously sad to lose Arnie, tremendously awful to watch Ginger have to go through this stuff with these people attacking her falsely on these insane things that are just not true. I mean, I flew down there and I helped her with the memorial for him. And stuff that some people were saying was just not true. And she had the facts to show me. And it was like, hello? So anyway, all of us, there's one thing that more than anything we all can use, and that's compassion and love. That's it. That's what's happening on this planet, kids. And if you're not happy, you have to remember what you give out is what you will get back. Right? If you give out love, you will get love back. If you give out shit, guess what's coming your way? And that's the way it goes down. That's the way it is on this planet. It's very real to me. So, you know, the Beatles said it, you know, love is all there is. And you know what? That's really all there is. That's it. Now the see? All right, stop freezing. Okay. Now, there you go. It's back. It's weird the way my camera will freeze. I don't know what that is. But anyway, something. If somebody knows it, call me and let me know. So anyway, I want to send you all love. I have a lot of different hearts around because they remind me of love. I have, I have angels too because I believe in angels. And this was from a dear friend of ours who sent me this before she passed away, Denise. So anyway, to all of our friends that have passed away, I love you. I miss you. To all of you that are alive and well, please celebrate your life. Please enjoy your life. Please give thanks for everything that you do have. I know a lot of people get stuck in what they don't have. But if you concentrate more on what you do have, you will be a lot happier than if you concentrate on what you don't have. And I know a lot of people that have a lot of stuff and they're not happy. So, and this is true because of my parents. I knew a lot of people that were millionaires, multimillionaires, and they were very unhappy. Not all of them. I'm not saying you can't be wealthy and be happy. I know friends that are very wealthy and very happy. But it takes time and it takes enjoying your life and doing things and having friends around you and, you know, just enjoying life however you can. So it's there you go. That's all I'm going to say to Arnie Lerma. May he fly high. I don't think he's going to be resting in peace. I know him. He's not a resting kind of guy. He's somewhere, probably kicking ass somewhere. Anyway, I love you guys. Thank you for listening and have a wonderful weekend. Bye-bye.